This last weekend, Fabrizio Anteri at GP Manchester mm-hmm. was disqualified.
In the first round.
Yeah, for deck manipulation. It was like right away, it seemed like.
Yeah, I was shocked. I just woke up and I saw
that. That's exactly what I did too.
Yeah.
Kind of even more shocking is Fabrizio was a member of Eureka.
Yeah.
Team Eureka, and they have a great reputation. Like
right.
they are the European team,
right.
I would say. And I think they were on pins and needles. Big Z is friends with Fabrizio. I know Joel Larson.
And all those guys, nobody thinks anything. You know, everybody's like, these guys are clean, legit.
Yeah.
They're very good Magic players.
What's going on here?
They're also very nice. I like know all of them.
They're super nice guys.
They're awesome guys.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So,
and
I think it put them in an awkward spot. And you saw, I mean, I think Big Z was out there saying, hey, we're just going to wait to see what the investigation reveals.
Right.
Of course, Team Eureka has already posted a statement. So you can look at any kind of social media outlet that any of these guys are on, Twitter, Facebook, whatever. Any member of Team Eureka, I think they've got it on there. And Terry, banned for 18 months. Suspended for 18 months.
Yeah.
Through 2018.
Yeah, so this was a result of, basically, I guess he had a small history, or the judges were told to look for something.
Mm-hmm.
And so in his first round at Grand Prix Manchester, judges kept eyes on him, and they noticed that he was basically mana weaving, manipulating his deck. So you always have a good distribution of land spells or whatever. And some people do that. You know, just going through your deck, and you're like, oh, I got four Splinter Twins in a row.
Yeah.
Let's mix it up. But then afterwards, people just like shuffle it. It's like a suspicion thing, right? People shuffle it. It's not something you should be doing, but I think a lot of people have done that.
Of course.
You know, but then you shuffle. The thing here is he was doing this kind of mana weaving thing, but then he wasn't sufficiently randomizing.
Right.
He didn't shuffle his deck, and he just presented his deck, and that's basically stacking the deck. After the investigation, 18 months. That's a long time.
18 months is huge. I mean, the hammer got dropped. I mean, I was thinking...
Because that basically just means Wizards just basically are just saying, yeah, you cheated.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, I mean, I think kind of estimates were between, I would say between 6 and 12.
I thought 6,
I think 6 and 12, and I thought 12 was kind of the outside, and I thought like 6 to 8 is kind of the actual range, but 6 to 12 is where I saw discussion. And then I saw 18, and I was like, wow.
Yeah. Magic was basically like, it was a huge part of his life. You know, he was crushing it this year.
Yeah, he was doing well.
Now we're kind of looking at like...
It's dubious.
You know,
it's dubious now,
yeah.
Right?
And, and he was a Platinum Pro.
Yeah.
So, he was well set up for next year, and this is a huge blow. And, I don't really know too much about him. This is pretty big. And I think the way that Eureka actually handled the situation was amazing.
Yep.
They did a really great job. If you just go to their Twitter page or whatever.
Yep.
Check out the statement. It was great. You know, they basically were like, hey, temporarily, we're going to kind of suspend them until we figure out what exactly happens. If, they go with nothing, then we're still going to have to reevaluate.
Figure out, yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. But if they do decide to go through with a banning or a suspension, then we're going to have to drop him from the team for obvious reasons. And I think, they did a really good job with that.
It's really tough, and you can obviously speak to this way more than I or most people watching it. Like, when I was reading this, because I know Big Z and I know Yoel, and they're really nice guys, talk to them at all these events, they're just really nice guys. And I think to myself, what kind of position are they in here? They're not doing this.
Yeah.
They didn't do this. But, a member of their team did. And when you're kind of on the same team, there's a sense you're vouching for each other.
Right.
Right? Because even if you don't know someone, like if you don't know, if you don't know Webb, but he's, test with CFB and I know you and I know Luis, I'm going to give Webb that credibility.
Right.
So these guys are stuck out there on a limb. Particularly when an 18-month ban hammer drops, what kind of position does that put you in if that's someone on your team or if that's something that you're going through?
Yeah, I know. It's really difficult. Like, once again, I mean, you look at the guys from Team Eureka, they're just known, they have a very good reputation, very nice guys, very clean guys, and this happened. And it put a lot of pressure on them. And like I said, I admire kind of, they went about it the right way.
Mm-hmm.
And, this is all just kind of unfortunate news. At the same time, if he was truly stacking his deck and doing this, then, well, that's cheating. And, the 18-month ban is appropriate. So.
Yeah.
Like I said, I don't know too much about it, but apparently the judges were looking after this, which means something happened prior to this event
I'll give you some inside baseball here, because there are different judges, because there are different judges, a lot of them, at least in domestically and on the West Coast, who are magicians as well. So their card, you know, they know how to manipulate cards. And so it happens at main events all the time where it's like, oh, hey, you know, Paul, can you go take a look at the players in table 363?
Yeah.
We're worried about some shuffling. So it's something that judges are super conscious of. And there are judges who are much better, who practice sleight of hand as a hobby. Like, if you're a magician,
if you're
really
a judge,
that.
That's actually, yeah, it's good to know.
And so it's definitely part of, you know, one of the things we talk about at Grand Prix from the TO side, from the judging side, is active, like proactive judging. Watch magic, you know. And one of the things that drives me nuts is if there's just a whole group of judges that are just talking to each other.
Because
you know, you want them out there watching, because a lot of times that's how you catch this stuff.
Right.
Okay, that's what you see. I mean, it's a rare instance when... but it does happen where your opponent shuffles in a way, he presents, and you just go, judge, right?
I mean, this makes me more, like, a bit more scared personally, because, you know, I always just, you know, like, you know, and especially at the Grand Prix level, so many more people just, like, cut your deck. Mm-hmm. You know, it feels weird for me, too, because, like, you know, at the Pro Tour, everybody always shuffles each other's decks, right? And I almost get that instinct when somebody, like, somebody just a seemingly friendly person at the Grand Prix plays against me and just cuts my deck. I feel like I should cut them back almost.
Nope.
I
mean, no, I'm always shuffle your opponent's
deck. I'm just
deck.
Saying,
you
but,
always
but
shuffle
like
it.
I get that feel just because it's like, oh, this guy looks like a pretty nice guy and he just cut my deck. He trusts me. All right, let's play magic. You know, it's a game.
I play for fun. Right. Well, I mean, I never play in a competitive setting. So for me, I think that's fine because you know, to me, it's like if I really think you're cheating, I'm just going to stop playing with you.
Right.
I think, you know, competitive, you know, and the times I've been in PTQs and stuff, I've shuffled my opponent's deck. I've been like, hey, I'm going to shuffle your deck. Don't feel bad about shuffling mine. And I think it's fine to just say that. You know, it's just and it's a good habit to be in. You should always shuffle your opponent's deck. When your opponent shuffles your deck, even if you're just cutting theirs, they're just being practical. It's just, I think it's the way you play competitive magic.
I've also had situations where, like, my opponent's about to cut my deck, and then, like, I pick up their deck to shuffle it, and they're like, all right, hold on, just kidding, I'm going to shuffle you too.
Yeah, yeah.
And, so, well, you know, obviously I don't care, but it's just kind of funny. They're like, oh, he's shuffling my deck. Well, I'm shuffling
you
back.
Well, I'm going to shuffle your deck then, buddy. How do you feel about it?
Well, good, you know, I want you to sufficiently randomize my deck.
No, I mean, it's the way to play Magic, seriously. Right. You know, it's not a trust thing. You know, we're not playing on the kitchen table here. We're playing at a Grand Prix.
Yeah.
And there's real legitimate prizes on the table. There's no reason not to do it. And it's not, you know... You can't take offense to that. That's just that's really how you know. That's how you should play Magic in that environment.
And I mean, they're definitely now setting the precedent. You know, people. I think a lot of people have been guilty of just randomly like looking through their deck and be like, oh, well, this is kind of too. You know, there's too many cards all clumped together. Let's just separate it and shuffle. Mm-hmm. You know, I think people have done that, and now it's like, no, you just don't do that. If you see a clump, whatever, just make sure you shuffle well, and that's what you're just supposed to do. Yeah. And you know, or I mean, this is. You know, kind of the top end of the punishment you could receive.
You need to, make sure it's sufficiently randomized.
Yeah, yeah.
And Terry getting the 18-month ban hammer, huge cost.
That is big. Actually, England's gonna have a new team captain.
Wow.
Because he was firmly ahead.
Yeah, way ahead. Yeah. So I mean, and just to put that in scale for the professional Magic community, that's going from Platinum Pro to start sleeving up for the PPTQs in 18 months.
Likely going to do other things, but what I see a lot of the times from when this happens is people usually come back. You know, you spend this much like he's obviously a very very good Magic player, you know, and so you know I imagine he'll be back and hopefully.
Look, man, I do with all kinds of stuff. Anymore. You know, at GPs internally here at the warehouse. Whenever I have these hard discussions with people, I only ask for one thing, and that's just learn from the experience.
Yeah,
there's you do bad things that you know, and you get caught. You're caught. That's it. It's done. You're not going to change that. Learn from it. That's the only silver lining possible in so many scenarios. So I hope that there's a lesson here.
Yeah. All right.